So recently I saw Disney on Ice's latest production Frozen Encanto. Upon first glance, I thought it was interesting how they would pull off the double feature aspect considering this is the second show billed as a big double feature event with the first being double feature in 1991, but when I did see it, it was okay, but it does pose a problem that most modern Disney on Ice shows they have. In the words of Mickey, as he mentions it, in 75% of the shows Frozen is included in, why even bother explaining when he himself can explain it?
About two sisters who live in a place called Arendelle.
Olaf narrates a story, and he immediately gets on my nerves after his first narration. Hans is still a terrible twist villain, the only good song is not in this anymore, and I don't have any feelings towards this bland film anymore. But let's not talk about that segment, let's talk about Bruno instead.
We don't talk about Bruno.
Oh crap, I wasn't supposed to talk about him. Let's talk about the better segment, the latter half. I love Encanto, it's become my second favorite Disney movie, with Pinocchio still being in my top 3 and Beauty and the Beast still being number 1. I think it has such a strong message and a strong central cast. If we're being honest, I prefer the Disney movies where there are no too little animal side characters, or the animal that isn't a dog but acts like one. Yes, Sven is the only one, but we're talking about Bruno and Encanto. I think the segment really does a terrific job bringing the madrigals to life. While yes, some characters were removed like Antonio and Camillo, I think for this show it really didn't need them since the show focuses on two different movies. This issue would have been resolved unless you did the full movie on Ice like other shows. For the characters, they all look really good. I was a bit worried about some characters considering Disney on Ice's track record for creating costumes that can cause nightmares, including Maui, the enchanted objects, Olaf, but they managed to make them all human, which is a good sign that they took their time with this incredible film. To me, the best song in the production is the family madrigal, because it gives off the vibes of a classic full-length film adaptation Disney on Ice show like Beauty and the Beast, in terms of composition instead of being a duplicate of the movie. We don't talk about Bruno. While I'm not a huge fan of things being done verbatim from the movie, I think it's a fun ensemble number. Even Camillo appears in Bruno clad disguise. Oh wait, I forgot he wasn't in the show, so I guess that was his only appearance. I loved Surface Pressure, the donkeys were phenomenal and very funny. And Louisa juggling the world on her shoulders, yeah, that's pretty cool. Oh yeah, she also mentioned Hercules at one point. With the trivia question and celebrate memories and the reference of him in Surface Pressure, I'm starting to notice a pattern. Is Fel trying to tell us something? Or maybe I'm being superstitious just like Bruno. Speaking of spurs, I love the effects they did for Bruno's vision. The fire on the eyes looked amazing, and is one of my favorite effects that has ever been done this past decade. Speaking of effects, the aerial artistry of Isabella is art. The weather for Peppa, amazing. The comedy timing of Felix talking about Bruno is comedy gold, funnier than the long and drawn out bench routine and Happy Birthday Donald. It's short, sweet, and to the point. Also, he helped out with the pre-show, which I loved. It's a short but sweet pre-show, but is a really nice addition, especially considering that the show didn't have any hosts. And now, let's talk about the Fat Four. I think that despite being a show about Frozen and Canto, they definitely get a bit more time to shine, appearing at the end of each segment like the original double feature. And they get a nice little storyline where they encourage Arnold to use the power of imagination, and hey, I really like that. It's much better than the Arnold, I don't believe in dreams, she took in Dream along with Mickey, because he gives hope in it instead of being the anti-hero, he was in Dream along with Mickey. Plus he is the one who imagines the Encanto segment, and he's my favorite out of the Mickey crew, and that's amazing. But there's more than the Mickey crew here. I think it's nice that characters from Mona, Coco, Little Mermaid, Mulan, Beauty and the Beast, and...
God, I'm freaking out! What was his name?
Aladdin?
Aladdin?
Mm-hmm.
All get a chance to appear at the end. But I am weirded out by one thing. No Toy Story. Yes. Honestly, I was quite surprised they weren't there in the show considering they've been a staple in Disney on Ice, especially in the 2010s, but it felt weird but I didn't miss them as much. But hey, at least they're on the program cover, so that makes up for it. Considering that the show has so many great characters, I wonder how it's going to play out if they add Encanto to every show, and maybe finally get rid of 100 Years of Magic, which is due to retire anytime this next decade. If this were a full Encanto show, I would give this a 7 out of 10. But since Frozen is there, it's a 5 out of 10. And I look forward to what Disney on Ice does this decade.